Hi everyone, welcome back to Wes Knows Tech News and Reviews. Today we'll be doing another test and comparison. And why do we do them? Well, because they're so much more fun and insightful than just looking at the two smart trackers or smartwatches. Okay, so today we'll be testing the heart rate accuracy of the GTS 2 Mini as well as the Huawei Band 6. So without further ado, let's get into it. Being fair, the weather has been absolutely shocking the last couple of days. But finally, we do have a dry spot, so I'm out here in the forest and we're going to be talking about the GTS 2 Mini, which is just a wow smartwatch. So that's the cheapest smartwatch in the Amazfit smartwatch range. But nonetheless, it just keeps kicking ass. It basically destroyed the GTR 2e as well as the GTS 2e by heart rate accuracy as well as GPS accuracy. On top of that, it's very close to the heart rate accuracy of the flagships. That's the GTS 2 as well as the GTR 2. And then of course we do have the all new Huawei Band 6. Now the Huawei Band 6 is famous for all the different reasons, mostly because it is one of the cheapest trackers in the world to offer continuous SpO2 monitoring. So today we're taking these two giants, well, in a sense, and we're comparing them and testing them for their heart rate accuracy. Let me tell you quickly about the two trackers and then we'll get into the numbers. And now quickly about the GTS 2 Mini. So as we mentioned, this is the cheapest smartwatch in the Amazfit smartwatch lineup. And what does it have? Well, it's got a huge 1.55-inch AMOLED display. Now that's 288 PPI, so that's 288 pixels per inch. That's quite a good resolution for such a budget smartwatch. When I'm talking budget, I do mean budget, as in cheap. It's only £69 or $80. So this is as cheap as it gets for a smartwatch, which's got over 70 sport modes. It's got inbuilt dual GPS. It can track your sleep with three sleep stages. So your light, your deep and REM sleep. It's got continuous stress monitoring, continuous heart rate monitoring. It can help you manage your time with the Pomodoro tracker. It's got a compass. It's got a barometer. It's got a lot of functionality. It can actually measure your SpO2 as well, even though just in spot mode or on demand. Now that's not as helpful as what the Huawei Band 6 can do with continuous SpO2 monitoring, but nonetheless, it's very useful. As well as that, the GTS 2 Mini actually has Alexa. So that's your onboard assistant, which you can use to set alarms, record your shopping list, and ask for the weather, and so forth. Because right now I'd be asking, is it going to rain in the next 15-20 minutes while I'm filming this particular review? Anyway, let's talk about the Huawei Band 6. So the Huawei Band 6 is basically a lookalike of the more expensive Huawei Watch Fit. But if the Huawei Watch Fit costs just above the GTS 2 Mini, this bad boy is half the price. Now, I would say that the biggest difference between the Huawei Band 6 and the GTS 2 Mini, apart from the looks and some other functionalities, is the lack of inbuilt GPS. But what it does have is a huge 1.47-inch AMOLED display, and it's also edge-to-edge. There's no fat lip. It looks good. But if the GTS 2 Mini is actually sitting in an aluminium frame, the Huawei Band 6 is actually sitting in a plastic frame that looks like it's metal, but it's not. It's plastic. Well, it's got 95 sport modes. That's a whole lot of sport modes. It's also water resistant. It can track your stress, both all day stress as well as on demand stress. It can monitor your sleep also in three sleep stages. So you light, your deep and REM sleep, in fact, using True Sleep technology. Now, what True Sleep technology is famous for in the Huawei world is that this technology was actually developed in conjunction or with the Harvard Medical School. And when we're doing our sleep analysis and sleep tests, it does seem that True Sleep technology is one of the most accurate ones you can get on the market today. So it's got your alarms, it's got your weather widgets, it's got all the usual things. But for the most advanced bit, it might not have dual GPS as the GTS 2 Mini, It might not get Alexa, but what it does have is continuous SpO2 monitoring. Now, continuous SpO2 monitoring means that while at rest or while you're asleep, the watch is actually tracking your blood oxygen saturation. And only in this way can you actually pick up things like sleep apnea or lung problems or problems with your respiratory system. Now, this is a very, very functional tool. Anyways, so that's these two watches, and it does seem like it began pouring down. So I'm gonna go and stand under the canopy of a tree and we'll get into the numbers. Right, I found some trees, I found some cover. Well, still wet, but we have to finish this accuracy test. So basically, the benchmark for the accuracy test was, as per usual, the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So I wear it on my chest while I'm doing a particular exercise. And in this particular case, I was actually recording my heart rate while I was at the gym. So for just under 30 minutes, I was on the treadmill, then doing some exercises with weights as well as core exercises. So something like lunges, squats, and so forth. Let's see what the Polar H10 actually recorded. And we can see that we've got the heart rate average sitting at 117 beats per minute, while the max was actually registered at 137 beats per minute. Let's take a look at what the GTS 2 Mini has come up with. And as always, the GTS 2 Mini basically wows us. It came up with almost amazing results. So we have to understand that we're actually talking about the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the smartwatch. Now, the optical heart rate sensor is really not as accurate as a full-on chest strap, simply because the chest strap is actually sitting right on our chest, right next to the heart, while the optical heart rate sensor is actually registering your heartbeat by emitting green LED light onto your skin and catching its reflection rate and how much green light is actually reflecting back to the photodiode. So basically, we really should not be seeing such a great heart rate accuracy. But we do, because the GTS 2 Mini just wows us with the results. Anyway, let's take a look. So it actually came up with an average heart rate of 119 beats per minute, and the max was 139 beats per minute. So we are talking about 2 beats per minute overstatement on both the average as well as the max. And that means on the average, that's an overstatement by 1.7%, while on the max, that's an overstatement by just 1.4%. This is just astounding results. Okay, so now let's take a look at the Huawei Band 6 and its results. Well, what can I tell you? The Huawei Band 6 actually does use TrueScene 2.0. What's TrueScene? So TrueScene is the technology with which your heart rate is actually registered. So if previously on the prior models we had the TrueScene 1.0, now this is the next generation, and it should mean that we're expecting better results. Well, let's take a look at the numbers. So we see an average heart rate registered at 117 beats per minute. That's on the dot. That's just wow. But the max is overstated by 4 beats per minute at 141 beats per minute. What does that mean? Well, that means that we do have an overstatement by just under 3%. But that's for the max. And that's basically an overstatement on one or two of the peaks. But the average is on the dot. So what can we say? We've got the GTS 2 Mini, which is a great smartwatch. And if you do need a GPS tracker, well, the GTS 2 Mini is the most budget and one of the most accurate GPS trackers out there with smartwatch capability and 70 sport modes. But if you don't need the GPS capability, you just need a lot of sport modes. You've got 90 plus on the Huawei Band 6, and you don't want to spend an arm and a leg, then just go for the tracker, because additionally, you'll also have continuous SpO2. And we can see that both trackers are very accurate indeed. Anyway, thank you for watching this comparison and heart rate accuracy test. If you found it useful, please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Please click the red subscribe button below the video, and we'll see you in the next one.